Hi, this is Sangeetha Davla, now going to introduce you to the topic cancer. Yes, the most dreaded disease that definitely ends in death. The main objective of this chapter is introduce you to the topic cancer and focus on those aspects as to why it is called a psychophysiological disorder. We will also look into the various psychosocial aspects that are related to cancer. What is cancer? Cancer refers to a condition where there is one or a large number of diseases that are categorized by the development of abnormal cells, and these abnormal cells are found to divide uncontrollably and they infiltrate into the entire body, thereby damaging and affecting the different organs within the body. Cancer has the ability to spread rapidly. Mind you, they spread at a maddening speed throughout the entire body. This disease has been touted as the second most leading cause of death across the world. The survival rates, however, are improving nowadays. Why? Because of the kind of treatment procedures that the doctors have been coming up with, and also because of the improvement in the screening methods when the initial tests are done. There are, of course, a lot of treatment options that the cancer patients can choose. But one thing is for sure, a diagnosis of cancer is definitely going to have a debilitating effect on the minds of the patients. It is a widely known fact also that cancer changes a whole lot of aspects that are related to a person, and this change is definitely a dramatic change. There are a lot of psychosocial effects. They can actually be very overwhelming when a person learns that he has been diagnosed with cancer. What are the various psychosocial effects? What reaction does this elicit when people in your own family learn about this condition, when your friends come to learn about this condition? What is going to be your plight at a later stage of cancer? All these thoughts will definitely add up to the stress that this particular disorder brings about. First and foremost, the diagnosis of cancer will bring about an influx of a myriad range of emotions. You may cry, you may be scared, you may be stressed, and probably you will cry your heart out that day itself, thinking as if that were the end of your life. But with the kind of options in treatment as well as psychological support that we have now, it definitely is not the end of life. We have seen winners like Yuvraj Singh, winners in Manisha Koirala, and many other famous personalities who have battled out this monster disease called cancer. No doubt, there are going to be a lot of physical effects, but you will have to handle the emotional effects as well as the psychological effects too, that are going to add up to the medical effects. So, it calls for a lot of effort from your end, and it is not only from the patient's end, it is also extra requirement from the support staff or support system in the family also. Most of the patients who are diagnosed with cancer know perfectly well that it is the end of their life, but how happily they are going to reach the final destination point is dependent on how they tackle the in between symptoms, in between conditions. There are a lot of changes that set in from the time the diagnosis has been made, then throughout the treatment, and then for the remaining part of their life. So, the earlier a cancerous condition is detected, earlier can the treatment be started, and the person's time that takes to reach the final or the advanced stage can be prolonged or delayed to a great extent. How will you know that a person is suffering from cancer. Generally, this is one disease that people will not be aware of until and unless they have reached the secondary stage. Detecting cancer in the initial stages is a rare scenario. A few of the cancers are detected by a self-routine examination or with the help of a few screening measures. That is why they say once a person is 40 and plus, it is essential for him to go in for an annual checkup, wherein any such indications will be known and the right action can be taken, the right intervention strategy can be employed to curtail the spread of the disease any further. In some cases, it is diagnosed incidentally while evaluating some other disease. While evaluating some other disease or a medical condition. Once the diagnosis is done, there are a series of tests that are performed again in order to identify the intensity of the disease and also draw more detailed information as to how much of the bad of this cancer has spread into the body. What are the various symptoms of cancer? The symptoms depend greatly on the kind of body part that is affected with cancer. A few of the general symptoms that are associated with cancer are: there is a drastic weight drop in the person. The person experiences fever very frequently. There is fatigue. The skin changes, like it becomes dark, or certain patches on the skin become yellowish in color. There is a change in the bladder and bowel habits. There are unexplained muscle pains and joint pains that the person experiences, and there is difficulty in swallowing at times. These are just a few symptoms that may occur in few types of cancer. As we are aware, there are different types of cancers that are known to people now. Each one of them might experience just one or two of these symptoms that we have discussed just now. Etiology of cancer. The exact cause is not known, but there are some factors that definitely influence the development of cancer. What are these factors? First and foremost, it is the biological influences. Certain cancers, like those of the stomach, breast, colon, kidney, the lungs, all of them follow a certain familial pattern. Whether this indicates an inherited susceptibility or they are because of some common exposure to the etiological factor is unknown. Continuous irritation also may predispose individuals to developing cancer. For example, when a person is chronically exposed to sunlight, there is always a risk that he is predisposed to getting melanoma. This is a condition where it lands him in skin cancer. Prolonged alcohol consumption may also be related to development of esophageal cancer. Prolonged consumption of kaini or jarda or tobacco in its direct form may lead to throat cancer. Exposure to certain chemicals or occupational carcinogens or the environmental carcinogens may also result in specific types of cancer. For example, cigarette smoking. Even the passive smokers stand a risk of developing esophageal cancer. You can also take the exposure to asbestos. Frequent exposure and exposure for long periods of time also will result in cancer for those people. Various drugs have been implicated in the onset of cancer. They include immune suppressive agents and radioisotopes. Certain viruses have been found to be responsible for getting certain types of cancer. However, the role that these viruses play in the cause of cancer in humans has not been definitely established. That was the biological influence of cancer. Now, when we look at the psychological influence of cancer, we see that there are a number of research studies that have focused on the personality characteristics of the person and his predisposition to developing the conditions. These researchers have come up with a terminology called the type C personality. It has been coined to describe those characteristics that are found in the people who have higher predisposition to develop cancer. Cancer has sometimes been called the nice guy's disease. Common characteristics that were found to be associated with the type C personality include repression of negative emotions. When you suppress your negative emotions for long periods of time, there is an increased chance that you might develop cancer in the long run. These people are found to be overly cooperative. There is a lot of passivity in them and they are extra apologetic in nature. Other researchers who have studied these characteristics identify these characteristics in the type C personality. This person suppresses anger for long duration of time and he has a lot of hostility bottled up in him. Even though he has such kind of anger suppressed in him, his exterior is something that of a very calm and a placid character. Commonly, he is depressed and he is always in despair. He has very low self-esteem levels and has a very low self-worth. As we mentioned earlier, he is extra cooperative. He puts others' needs before his own needs. He has a tendency toward self-pity and he sets an unrealistic standard and is inflexible in the enforcement of these standards. In short, they are perfectionists and if they do not reach that ideal stage, there is a lot of dissatisfaction and despair that sets in. Research, however, does not completely support or does not completely negate the influence of these psychosocial factors on the development of disease cancer. People who are depressed for long periods of time are found to have higher chances of developing cancer in the long run. The ability to express one's emotions rather than repress them has been shown to have an association with positive cancer prognosis. It has always helped to talk it out rather than keeping all the emotions bottled within yourself. This talking out is called catharsis. You need to have a vent for your emotions. If you do not do so, there are various other things that tend to develop and these things cause a serious impediment to your own life. Therefore, this person, when he is encouraged to talk, when he is encouraged to express his anger, will definitely feel less predisposed to getting the condition called cancer. When there is a lack of closeness with the parents, more so with the mother, when the person is less satisfactory about his interpersonal relationships, all these things have been found to have a certain kind of influence on the person's risk of developing cancer at a later point in time. Variables of positive relationships have been associated with increased survival rates. When a person is diagnosed with cancer and he gets positive support from the family, he is encouraged, he is taught to manage his condition well, the chances of extension of life are higher. He will deal with his condition in a very positive manner. One very live example is Akineni Nageswarrao Garu, who has been diagnosed with cancer at the age of 90. Despite knowing the final outcome of the condition, he came in front of the media to say he is ready to battle it out. He feels very energetic. Such is the kind of optimism that each and every patient has to be taught, each and every patient should inculcate in his own self. When there is lot of positivity, when there is lot of optimism, any amount of danger, any amount of frustration can be tackled easily. Treatment of cancer. Is cancer curable? This is a million-dollar question. With the kind of advancements we have seen in the medical field, some kinds of cancer are definitely curable. Based on the type of cancer and the stage in which it is in, treatment is meted out to the patient so as to eradicate the disease completely or to help him cope with his condition in a better manner. Treatment is generally in the form of surgery, and post-surgery it is definitely accompanied with chemotherapy or radiation therapy based upon the condition of the cancer patient. The number of chemotherapies will be decided by the doctor, of course, depending upon the extent of the spread of this cancer in the body. What role does support play in dealing with a disease like cancer? Cancer support is found to play a very significant role and would help the person tackle his condition in a better manner. Support has to be extended to the patient from the healthcare provider first. It has to be extended from the nurses and also from the other professionals who are involved with the treatment procedure. The main goal of the support system is to maintain general health of the patient and relieve other symptoms that come along with this condition and improve the overall quality of life of the patient. Their job is to offer psychological support as well as emotional support to the patient and to the family as well. The patient is shocked, that is fine. The family also is equally shocked. So, the initial phase of the treatment will be to talk to the patient at length, to talk to the significant family members also at length, and describe to them the kinds of procedures, the kinds of treatment that are being used to help eradicate cancer completely or to help the person cope with his condition comfortably. Now, such kind of cancer support is possible only when the initial treatment has been given to the patient. How does exercise have an effect on cancer? Can cancer patients participate in some kind of a physical exercise? It is found that exercise can definitely help tackle fatigue, anxiety, and also muscle tension. Exercises like swimming and walking are found to be effective in making the person relax and breathe in some kind of fresh air. This way, he will be able to relax his strained muscles. The right kind of exercise has been found to better the outcomes that are associated with the treatment of cancer. How can cancer be managed? We will now look into the effective management of cancer. As mentioned earlier, surgery perhaps is the only option that we have to come out of this dreadful condition. But is that going to solve the problem? Is the person's life assured from then on? No. There are surgical procedures that can be used to diagnose malignancy, that is, a sample is taken from the patient's body and is sent for biopsy. This kind of surgery is used to ascertain the level of malignancy that is present in the body. There are a few surgical options also to cure these malignancies. For instance, if there is cancer in the ovaries, hysterectomy is performed. If it is a case of cancer in the breast, mastectomy is performed. There is surgery for rehabilitation measures also, like breast reconstruction is one of the procedures that can be taken to after a mastectomy has been performed on the patient. So, as you can see, there are quite a lot of medical procedures and medical treatments that will help a person tackle this condition in an effective manner. There are surgeries for various other purposes also, which are found to improve the quality of life of these cancer patients. Radiation therapy is one kind of treatment procedure we generally hear with cancer patients. Now, what is radiation therapy? Radiation therapy is the use of high energy ionizing emissions from a radioactive source to eradicate the malignant tumors with as little damage done to the normal tissues, and this procedure will definitely arrest the multiplication of the damaged cells from spreading into other parts of the body and other important organs of the body. When this kind of spread is halted, is eradicated, the life expectancy of the cancer patient is definitely increased. Radiation therapy can be used either singly or it can be used in combination with other treatment procedures. Radiation therapy can be used either singly or can be used with other treatment procedures so as to get total control over the tumor and so as to stop the spread of this tumor to other places in the body. It is also used as a palliative measure to control the pain of bone metastasis in clients with advanced neoplastic disease. There is a case of stem cell transplant, biological therapy, hormone therapy, and targeted drug therapy. All of these are treatment procedures which are used in treating cancer. Now, once the cancer patient has undergone these surgical treatments, once he has undergone radiation therapy or chemotherapy, what is the kind of dietary care that is to be taken? This he needs to talk to his dietitian or his specialist himself and then adhere to the dietary regimen that has been mentioned by them. The selection of foods also has been determined to have an effect on the way the disease can be managed. There has been a lot of controversy regarding the aspect of diet that the cancer patients can have. Some opine that they should stick to bland diet and some say that the person can have his spicy diet, but having spicy foods may cause some conditions like dyspepsia in a few individuals, which is again another type of a health complication. Reduction in the consumption of coffee or caffeine is strongly recommended. The cancer patient has to give up the habit of drinking if he is used to consuming alcohol on a regular basis. Smoking, of course, is a strict no, and at the same time, using drugs like aspirin has to be definitely avoided. It is a known fact that a disease like cancer will bring about a lot of psychological after effects. Now, surgery also might bring in depression into the mind of the cancer patient. Given that depression and stress have a lot of influence on cancer biology, it has been seen that some kind of psychological support when it is offered to the patient will help him tackle his condition in a better manner. Now, what are the various kinds of behavioral support and psychological support that are offered to the cancer patient? They include cognitive behavioral therapy and stress management techniques, support groups and psychoeducation, all of which have a positive effect on the minds of the cancer patient. First and foremost, when he attends a self-help group, he will understand that there are so many others who are successfully handling the most dreaded disease called cancer. There are interventions that enhance social support, they teach relaxation techniques, and they also teach coping skills which will improve the neuroendocrine and cellular immune functioning of the person. One thing we can affirm that the way in which people are psychologically affected by cancer differs, and this is based on a variety of factors that includes the prognosis, that includes the kind of treatment that has been chosen, and also on the kind of pain that the person suffers from. There are a lot of after effects that the cancer patient has to put up with. Fatigue is one condition, and this has been found to affect the overall quality of life of the person as he is unable to do his daily activities like he used to do earlier. What are the various risk factors of cancer? Age. Cancer is a condition which takes a lot of time to develop, and it is basically because of this reason that its diagnosis also is made only late, and it is found to affect people who are 60 years or older. However, this case does not hold good for all types of cancer. Lifestyle habits. People who make lifestyle choices like smoking, drinking, excessive exposure to sun and excessive exposure to harmful carcinogens are more predisposed to getting some type of cancer or other. It is not necessary to say that cancer is always genetic. Before you rule out this factor, it is essential to go back into the family history and then ascertain the fact. Only less than 5% of cancers are considered to be hereditary. The external environment also is found to be greatly responsible of whether a person develops cancer or no. When you keep these risk factors in mind, it is definitely helpful to somehow reduce the intensity of these risk factors and manage your condition well so that you do not fall prey to this dreaded disease at all. There are a lot of psychological aspects that cancer brings in, and these difficulties are felt by the patient as well as his family members also. A perfect combination of the services and support from all the people involved with the help will definitely help in better management of cancer. Treatments like chemotherapy and radiation definitely are expensive, but at the same time, if they prove to be effective and if they ensure that the life of the person is assured, then you may go ahead with the kind of treatments that the doctor has suggested. Of course, some kinds of cancer treatments will bring in physical deformities. The person should be able to muster up courage to carry on with his life like he used to do earlier. There definitely are a lot of challenges that the cancer patient has to face. This is very much possible if he develops an optimistic attitude, if he gets support from his immediate family and also from the treatment experts.